We have heard the term common mold noise a few times now. To better understand these, let's talk about what we can do against them. You have surely seen one of these ferret beads before. These filter out common mold noise signals similar to this component here, a so-called common mold choke. It looks a bit complicated at first with its four connections, but it consists of only two wires wound around a single ferret core. So it's basically a transformer with the same number of windings, but we use the connections differently. The two lines in the circuit symbol show a core made of magnetic material, and the dots indicate the winding direction, which is very important. In one of our previous videos, you saw that common mode currents flow in the same direction into our DOT and return through the parasitic stray capacitances to our chassis. Therefore, let's consider what happens when we send this common mode current through a common mode choke. Let us first consider just one wire. The current through this wire results in a clockwise magnetic flux inside the ferret core. Now the current through the second wire also leads to a magnetic flux in the same direction. So the flux reinforces and the common mode current sees a large inductance. Thus the common mode radio frequency noise signal gets filtered by that high impedance. And what happens to the desired differential mode signal? In this case, the current in the second wire flows in the other direction. As a result, a counterclockwise magnetic flux flows inside the ferret core. Both magnetic fluxes then cancel each other out and the signal can pass the choke. But this is not the whole truth, because the world isn't ideal. In fact, both windings are not 100% equal. Thus, a small stray inductance shows up. We don't want to call this a parasitic element, because in fact, a small leakage inductance is even desirable. This leakage inductance is then often used in our LC filter to filter differential mode noise. In this way, we must not solder an extra filter coil, which saves space and costs. Our EMI filter finally may look something like this. Our input signal sees the common mode choke first. This is followed by so-called Y capacitors, which redirect high frequency currents to ground. These are additional common mode filter components. To suppress differential mode noise, we use a single X capacitor and take advantage of the differential mode inductance of our choke. And what is this ferret bead for now? Often, this is just a simple clamp-on ferret core located at the end of a cable or antenna. It works like the common mode choke explained before. A common mode signal sees a large inductance and is thus filtered.